So, our last meal before leaving to Paraguay. Buffet for $2 something.
So, welcome back from the last day. Let's go for shopping in South America.
Back to the shopping paradise of South America. I recently watched the TV show The Most Dangerous Borders in Latin America, and they were talking about Ciudad del Este. But this city is absolutely safe, and I really like the place, even if CNBC says it's one of the last places you would ever willingly travel to.
Really cheap here, the stuff. Shopping.
So this is our new Airbnb. $16 per night for the entire apartment. It's very interesting to see that the kitchen have no sink directly. The sink is over there, behind the bedroom. Here's a tired lady, nice TV. And here's the sink, and the other side, next to the bathroom, probably because of the water connections.
So, here at the bus station. Maybe we ask them here. I like the lava. Yeah, no, it's easy. They have lots of buses here, so I can film.
So I arrived in, where are we?
Asunción.
Asunción. I arrived in Asunción, it's the bus station. It's really hot. 37 degrees. It is summer in Paraguay. Hopefully we're gonna have a nice day. We had a sunset before, I forgot to take photos.
So I arrived in Asunción, let's film the new Airbnb before it gets messy. It was a bit dark since already evening, the bus trip took way too long. Here, this is our little balcony, and I really like our bed up here, under the roof. So it's really hot here, that's why we have two air conditioners. I think we have to let them run at full power to cool down.
I really like these meaty lentils I bought today. Look, it's a registered trademark, but it has nothing to do with Disney. Very interesting, and they're buying lentils with Mickey Mouse. So, and Francisca is mad because Do magic! So here we have lots of stuff, it's easy to make magic because we have ajo, we have lots of spices, we have harira, it is basically everything you asked me to buy, except the cauliflower. Cauliflower, but cauliflower is very expensive in Paraguay, so we're gonna buy these tomatoes, potatoes, and use it with potatoes. We want to order pizza again.
How should I do this? You boil the potatoes first?
Yeah.
What?
Yes, boil the potatoes.
And then what?
And then eat it. Where's the sauce?
Here we're in a cafe de Acca. It's a very traditional restaurant. Here we can find lots of local stuffs, like the chipita or sopa paraguaya. Yeah, and you can see lots of traditional things from the country. Yeah. Just monsters.
This is Au-Au, one of the seven legends of the Guarani mythology, and I found it worth mentioning as I just learned about it yesterday. There's also another monster which has a penis, it is so long he can make the women pregnant even without entering the house. But I guess the restaurant didn't want to use this one at the menu.
Also tiriri, very typical. So let's try tiriri. Cheesecake, very nice. And there's the sopa. Oh, is that? That's the soup. Yeah, oh, boy, soup. Empanada, see? Yeah, ice for Ella, Ella. See? Ice latte. Ah, yeah. Muchas gracias. See, this is our soup. But how come it be it's not liquid? How can the soup not be liquid? There's not a soup, we're lying. This is not okay. You wanna complain?
I think
cheese. Yes, yes. This is maybe a soup inside. You should
then
open it.
Cut it in the half and I give you the half there and you give me the half.
Okay. And still no soup inside. Oh, and here, yesterday was bigger. Yes, half, half. And these are easy to share. So it's like mate, you have all the herbs, but then you have ice cold water. Tasty, tasty. Mm, it's good.
They're not so good.
How do you like the table art?
Nice to see bars which has a playground. Hola. So another beer here. It's my sweetie. Watching football.
Wow.
Today, no? We're in a taxi and we're going to the city center to see the art museum today. Two more days left, then it's finally saying goodbye.
What do you mean with finally?
For now. Not finally, not forever. Yeah. So yeah. First time we've been here already like 5 days, and it's the first time we go to the city center.
Yes,
yes. Here maybe is a prison, what is the house?
We are actually staying in a district called Villa Mora, which is about a 20-minute taxi ride to the city center. So after 5 days, we finally found the time, or maybe the motivation, because we had plenty of time to visit the city center.
We go to the National Museum, but it's closed because of coronavirus. That's very unfortunate. It's very unfortunate that everything is closed here. By the way, here, my haircut is horrible. She did it.
Oh, yeah, let's do it again.
Yeah. Where do you want to go? The playground is closed. The city is really dead today because of the virus. So this railway museum is the only open museum today, but they charge the entrance fee of $1.60. So, okay. Yeah, sad. Classes are suspended. All cancelled. Yeah, COVID. Conocelo. Sintomas. Mausoleum is also closed. Everything is closed. It's not a good time to visit here.
Yeah, but I have vegan. And you have lots of meat.
So, back to the National Palace of Asunción. Heavily guarded palace here in Asunción. On the other side, and it seems to move the Asunción sign to here. Beautiful Asunción. Everything under lockdown.
Sunny.
Every place in Asunción. The Friendship, Paraguay, and Taiwan. You see here the Taipei 101. Very beautiful. Just next to the National Palace.
I think this is new here.
It wasn't there last year when I came here. So, on the other hand, well, it says 2017, so probably have been there, and I didn't notice it.
It's time to say goodbye. Any last words after the trip? So we're going to the airport now, saying goodbye, but not forever. I'll be back in Chile 1 month later, unless the borders are closed. Hopefully not. So yes, wonderful day. Sunny.
Alright, Franziska's gone. I just brought her to the airport this morning and now I'm just chilling the last 2 days before I'm going to Bolivia. I'm just afraid that because of the virus crisis they might be close to borders and I'm gonna stuck there. I already booked a flight from Iquique in North Chile to Santiago and then a month later from Santiago to Spain. So, and they're closing all the borders in Europe, which makes me worried about what's going to happen here. Even in Paraguay and Bolivia, they canceled all the flights to Europe already, so let's hope for the best. Oh, it's so beautiful and quiet here. Hey, here in Asunción, barely do anything because of the virus. Yeah. Germany is closing the borders, every country is closing the borders. I just booked a flight from Brazil to Chile because it was $100 cheaper, €100 cheaper. But I have to pay $10 for the bus, so I saved about $100. But I will take a 7-hour bus tomorrow, go back to Foz do Iguazu, and on Thursday, if everything is fine, I will fly back to Santiago de Chile. And let's hope the situation is improving soon. I mean, it's so quiet here. It's not so good.
No. Well, so now I'm going to the pharmacy, stock up on whatever they have, and yes, and get some food as well.
So it's already 7 a.m. It's time to leave Asunción. I really enjoyed this wonderful apartment here. It was really cool. Even though it was $25 a night, still not too expensive. So yeah, time to go back to Chile. I mean, first to Brazil, and then on Thursday to Chile. So back to Foster Iguazu, in fact. So, just waiting for my Uber, and then let's go. Just a toll. Yes, a gun. I guess some drivers didn't want to pay the $1.20 toll in the past, therefore they had to employ somebody with a shotgun. So I'm going back to Asunción because the border to Brazil is closed. So I just booked the flight to Santiago tomorrow, even though it was $210. Alright, let's see if it goes. It goes about Argentina and they closed borders too, so we will see. 7-hour bus ride and now this. They could have at least had warned me at the Asunción bus station. What they probably also didn't know.
I still can't believe what just happened today. I just got back to the apartment, which I just left this morning at 7 a.m. Now it's 8:13 p.m. 13-hour trip for nothing. The border to Brazil is closed. I was actually checking on the internet, but I couldn't find appropriate information. I should have just checked the government websites. If you just search for Paraguay coronavirus oil or noticias, there was nothing about it. So yeah, I took at 7:30 the bus NSA to Ciudad del Este, and I want to transfer to Foster Iguazu. And they said, no, today the border is closed. Only Brazilians can go over the border back to Brazil, or residents. Yeah, so Brazilians and Brazilian residents. Are you a resident? No, I'm not. So you can't go, they said. Oh, so what should I do? Is the airport open? I don't know. So I called the airport and they said, yeah, we're operating. So I booked the flight. I booked the flight already from Brazil because it was cheaper. It was 100 euro, like 110 US dollar. And on the way, when I went to Foster Iguazu, to Ciudad del Este, Francisca texted me, oh, Stefan, Chile is closing their borders on Wednesday. They won't let foreigners in, nobody in or out for Wednesday for 15 days. And then if the cases are getting more and more people infected, they are extended for 3 months. So, so quickly, I thought, I booked the flight for Thursday. So it's gonna be very short notice now, like it's gonna be too late. But so I was thinking in the bus and I thought, maybe I just go back to Taiwan. I checked flights from Sao Paulo, $800, not too bad, because now I pay almost $300 going back to Chile, yeah, from Asunción tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., less than 12 hours from now. So I thought, okay, if I go to Brazil, if I can't go to Chile, I go to Taiwan, because I have the Airbnb apartments in Taiwan and we don't have tourists, I'm losing money there. It's a bad, bad situation and I really have to go there to take care of the stuff. So anyways, they didn't let me out, so I said, okay, then let's go to Chile. I booked this $220 flight over Argentina tomorrow. Well, let's see. So I'm going to the airport. At 8:30 is the flight, so I go at 6:30 to the airport and then see how it goes. Hopefully I can go back to Chile. And I don't know, hopefully you just get out of Paraguay. I don't want to be in Paraguay. Please, let me out of here. So it's 5 a.m. now, but I can't sleep. I already woke up at 3:30, but I slept early yesterday, about 10:30. So yeah. Anyway, at 6 I go to the airport in 1 hour, 1.5 hour, flight is at 8:30. So I decide to just cut my hair. I think it's getting too long, right? Let's just cut the hair off. And that's how it's done. So, hair's off, took me like 1/2 hour. I hope it's fine. Let's see, feels weird, but also comfortable. You know, I like shorter hair because of the, when the weather, I like short hair when it's hot, basically. All the time, it's convenient, less hair gel and everything, just advantages.
So now I'm at the airport,
Yeah, looks like they're having strict controls. And hopefully I can leave today.
It's a really nice airport, quite empty.
So, it seems all normal here.
They had to consult if I could enter Chile, so I showed them my route application. So they had to call the official and then it was okay.
So, it seems all good.
And it's nice weather.
Crazy here.
Finally, I've made it to Buenos Aires. These days, everything is so uncertain, so you can't even plan where to go next. And my plans changed so many times. First, I'm going to go to Bolivia, then to Brazil, and now to Argentina. But here we are. And hopefully, I can take my flight back to Chile soon. Many flights were cancelled, but luckily, not mine.
Seems quite empty here.
I think usually it's more crowded.
So I'm having my 6-hour layover here. The airport, I think, never been so empty in decades.
I'm not sure if they even close completely soon. I think I cut the hair a bit too short as well.
Oh, finally I could make it into Chile. The last 4 hours before they closed the borders at midnight.
So I am authorized. So let's see, there must be a short line. It's pretty empty here. Katastrophe in Chile. Oh yeah, the borders are closed for 90 days. What should we do now? It's chaotic. Here's my breakfast.